गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इन चैप्टर नंबर 8 दैट इज एनिमल्स एवरीवेयर वी विल डू टॉपिक दैट इज गिवन ऑन पेज नंबर 75 ऑफ योर ईवीएस बुक. इफ यू विल सी हियर, दिस इज द टॉपिक दैट इज मूवमेंट इन एनिमल्स. दिस वी विल डिस्कस नाउ एंड इन दिस अंडर दिस टॉपिक वी विल डिस्कस टू टाइप ऑफ एनिमल्स दैट इज लैंड एनिमल्स एंड वाटर एनिमल्स एंड अदर्स वी विल डिस्कस tomorrow. So coming to the movement in animals, so first of all you should know what is movement. Movement means when a particular animal is moving from one place to another for one or any other purpose, that is known as movement. Now what is the importance of movement in animals, or you can say why the animals move? So we will see these lines here. This is the importance of the movement in animals. So topic is movement in animals. Why animals need to move? They need to move to search for food. For the searching of food, they move from one place to another. To protect themselves means to protect themselves from hunting and from any other reason, they move from one place to another. Third is to protect their babies from being hunted. So whenever the babies are there, they used to move from one place to another to protect their babies from enemies. And fourth is to build resting and breeding places. So to rest and for laying the eggs, or you can say for the birth of babies, they move from one place to another just to protect themselves from enemies, or you can say to get the proper environment for rest or for the breeding or for the breeding purposes. So all animals, they have different kind of parts which they use for moving, and they have different reasons that they why they move from each other, and there are different ways how they move from one place to another. So the animals have different body parts or limbs for movement, means they have different parts for the movement. Animals have different ways of moving from one place to another, and they have different ways also to move from one place to another. So first we will talk about the land animals. So we all know what are land animals. As the name indicating, the animals that live on land are called land animals. For example, horse, cow, dog, lion, etc. And most mammals have four limbs. We all know that they have four limbs, two in the front and most of them two at the back. So the four limbs, what are four limbs? The front limbs are called fore limbs, and hind limbs, the back limbs are called hind limbs. These four limbs and hind limbs diagram you can see in your book also. This I am showing you here. If you will see on page number, it is around page number 75. So this is given the diagram here, horse. So the front legs, these two, they are known as fore limbs, and the back legs, these two, they are known as hind limbs. So most of the mammals, they have four limbs, two in the front and two at the back. So now coming to the topic again, that most of the mammals, what they use four limbs for their movement. Now the next thing is that there are some animals which uses four limbs, but there are some animals also that uses two limbs, means with the two limbs they can move from one place to another. Now look here, some animals uses all four limbs to move, like horse, cow, cat, dogs, elephant, lion, tiger, and many more. But some animals use only hind limbs, means the back limbs, to move, like kangaroo, human beings, chimpanzees, baboons, and many more. And there are different ways of movement, there are different organs for movement. For example, the animals that jump, for example, frog, locust, it is an insect, kangaroo, they jump and then they move from one place to another. Animals that uses legs for moving, that I have told you, like crocodile, horse and deer. Animals that swim to move, so the animals which swim to move, like turtle, frog, penguins, fish, seahorse, etc., they use their fins or tails to move. This we will study in the next topic, in the water animals also. So this is regarding the land animals. Now coming to the next topic, that is the water animals. See here, as the name indicating, the water animals are the animals that live in water. They are known as water animals. For example, fish, turtle, seahorse, whale, penguins, starfish, etc. So one by one we will talk about the some water animals or aquatic animals, how they move. So we will do some new things regarding fish today. So this is the diagram of fish, and fish are having three kinds of fins. First, they are having unpaired fin, means only one fin is present on the upper side, that is known as unpaired fin. Here the spelling is written wrong, this is P, unpaired fin. Here two fins are present, that they are known as paired fins. And this is the tail, this is known as tail fin. Now what is the purpose of these fins in the fish? First of all, paired fin, these are the paired fin. What is they use? They are used to move forward. Now this unpaired fin, this one, what is the use of this unpaired fin? It maintains the balance of the fish in water. Third is this tail, this is known as tail fin. And what is its function? It's having very important function, that it helps to change the direction of movement in the water by fish. So this is regarding the fish. The fish uses all these three kind of fins for their movement in water. Now coming to the next thing is that turtles. How turtles move? They use their padded like limbs to push water back and to swim. So turtles use their padded like limbs to push water back so that they can swim in water. Penguins. Penguins uses four limbs as flippers to push water and to swim. They use their four limbs as flippers to push water back and to move forward. Now coming to the fourth, that is frogs. How frogs move? They have webbed feet. Webbed feet means they are having a many finger-like structure. This is known as webbed feet. And they use their webbed feet to swim in water. But when the frogs are on land, they jump with the help of their hind limbs, means with the help of their front limbs. So this is regarding your water animals and land animals, how they move. And tomorrow we will talk about that, how insects and birds move. That is the part of this topic only, movement in animals. So on the basis of today's topic, this will be your homework, and homework you can see in the assignment option of your app, and this you have to do in your rough notebook. Thank you and have a nice day.